Good morning, St. Pius parishioners and guests. Today we celebrate the Feast of the Immaculate Conception of the Blessed Virgin Mary. This feast celebrates God's choice of Mary to be the mother of Jesus. God preserved Mary from the stain of original sin from the moment of her conception. Thus, Mary was the first to receive the benefit of the redemption that her Son would merit for all. To reflect upon this mystery, the Gospel reading for today presents us to the story of the Annunciation. It is through her exchange with the angel Gabriel that Luke, the evangelist, introduces the person of Mary. The Annunciation begins in the context of Luke's account of the birth of John the Baptist. In the sixth month, referring to Elizabeth's pregnancy, the angel Gabriel appears to a virgin of Nazareth, Mary. Indeed, there are many parallels in Luke's account of the births of John the Baptist and Jesus. This is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The angel Gabriel was sent from God to a town of Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And coming to her, he said, "Hail, full of grace, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at what he said and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give him the throne of David, his father, and he will rule over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there will be no end." But Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I have no relations with a man?" And the angel said to her in reply, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, Elizabeth, your relative, has also conceived a son in her old age, and this is the sixth month for her who was called barren, for nothing will be impossible for God." Mary said, "Behold, I am the handmaid of the Lord. May it be done to me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. In this passage, Luke tells us much about Mary and the child she is to bear. We learn that Mary is a virgin from Nazareth who is betrothed to a man named Joseph, who was of the house of David. The angel greets Mary in the most glowing of terms, acknowledging the favor that she has found with God. The son Mary is to conceive is described in messianic terms. He will be called Son of the Most High and the Son of God. Mary is bold in her exchange with the angel. She's troubled by his greeting and questions the message, asking, "How am I to bear a son if I have no relations with a man?" Mary is told that she will conceive through the power of the Holy Spirit and is offered a sign in the miraculous pregnancy of her older cousin Elizabeth. Mary's affirmative response to this seemingly impossible message gives evidence to the grace we know that she possesses from God. Only one who is full of grace can be so receptive to and cooperative with the will of God. Because of this, Mary is the model of discipleship for all Christians. To be chosen by God for a particular task is a really awesome thing. That's why we honor Mary, the one chosen by God to be the mother of Jesus. Yet we believe that each of us is chosen by God in particular and important ways. And each of us is given gifts and talents by God to share with the world. One of the tremendous responsibilities of parenting is helping our children determine the gifts and talents they have to share with others to serve the reign of God. As a family this week, identify some of those gifts and talents that God has given each person in your family. Talk about the ways in which these gifts and talents might be used in the service of others. Recall that Mary was given a special task by God, and reflect upon Mary's humble response to God's call. Pray that each person you know will be like Mary and respond to God with a resounding yes by using their gifts and talents to serve others in both large and small ways. Let us conclude today with a simple Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We'll see you next week for the third Sunday of Advent. God bless.